Okay, so now that we've done the wireframe, let's look at three-axis projection. Okay, so we're going to create a new layer and make it active. All right, we want to use a curve, so we're going to do extract edges again. We're going to pick that curve, we'll say okay, and cancel. All right, from here, we're going to do the same thing. We'll go to the front view, line, angle. We're going to say absolute. Okay, so we put one there, put one there. Okay. From here, we're going to go back to a top view. We'll do 3D extrude curve. And we're just going to go... We basically want a curve here because we can drive a projection toolpath with this surface, so we're going to just create a new one and isolate it. Let's see. Right now, I'm trying to figure out what side it's going on and how far we want it to be, you know, so let's just have it go like this. Okay. So now you can see that's our surface, okay, that we're going to use to drive our toolpath. Now, we'll go into the cam tree. Okay, we're going to load a three axis. We're going to select our surfaces here. Okay, our strategy, we're going to delete these two. And we're going to look for project curves. Go over here. Alright, next step is to go to the tool. We're using the same tool. Next step is the pattern, so now it wants the curve, so we're going to click project curves, and then we're going to pick on the edges that we created over here. So that one, and that one. Okay, so we got it all selected. We'll scroll down to the bottom, alright, and we're going to just compute. Okay, so what it's going to do is it's going to tell you that there's geometry above the top of the surface, or above zero, and we're actually okay with that, but it won't let us create any toolpath until we adjust this. So we're going to just adjust this like that. Okay, and then now that gives us our projection toolpath. So the tool will come around, come down like that. Alright, if we want it to go the other way, we should be able to reverse this. And then recompute, and then backplot. Nope, that didn't do it. Let's go back in here. We'll switch it this way, and compute. Alright, so now we have it starting on this side and going that way. Or if you want it to go the other way, it's the same thing. You can switch it. Now it's going this way. Alright, so that's how we use project curves. Now with this one, you can also have it take multiple passes, right? So if we look at this one, we only get a single pass. Let's blank this. Alright. So with this one, we can edit this feature, and we can set a step distance and number of cuts, and we can tell it to cut to the geometry or cut from the geometry. This is an example of cutting to, so we're able to step down. When we look at this one here, right now we have a single pass. Okay, what this one will let you do is add multiple passes, so you could say offset, choose a side, and calculate. So this is going the wrong way. Let me edit that. Offset, right, number of passes. Okay, so now you can get it to take multiple passes this way. All right. But in order to get it to rough down in Z, you got to get a little more creative. Okay, and that's the reason why we drew this as its own surface here, So what we can do with this is translate it. So we'll select this and tell it to go up in Z 0.3. Okay, so now we moved it up. We'll go here, we'll say update all geometry, and go ahead and recompute it. Okay, it tells us the geometry is higher, so we need to adjust for that. So we'll just edit this. This is going to be 0.5. All right, it's going the wrong way because the reselection lost which side, so we'll just switch it. Okay, so now we have it doing multiple passes like this, but it's above the geometry. So now we're going to make copies and have it go down. So we right click on this. We go to Add Toolpath Pattern, Translate. From here, this is going to be 3. This is 0.1. We say OK. Oh, I'm sorry, I got to do a negative number. Edit. This is minus 0.1. Okay, and now we have it roughing that shape out and doing multiple step ins. In order to do the same over here, we would need to create more geometry. I guess we could also use a pattern, but maybe we would start at the front here and then pattern it this way in order to control cut order. All right, so that's 3-axis wireframe versus project curves.